Demi here. In this video, we are going to be talking about how you can market your real estate listing. Ding, ding, ding. Disclaimer, ladies and gentlemen, I am not a licensed real estate broker and I haven't tried selling a real estate property. So whatever advice that you are getting from here, it's not from a professional and it's up to you if you're going to take it or not. But I can attest that I have been transferring from one condominium unit to another 5 times specifically in the past 2 years because I really want to find a place where I can record nice videos, right? Or at least have a place that has a nice background like this one so that I can record nice and homey videos. And in the past 2 years of trying to find the best place, I have been disappointed. I have been extremely happy by the performance of property managers and real estate agents. And so I would be able to say a couple of tips and tricks here and there, combining my experience as a tenant and my experience as a digital marketer on how you can best market your real estate listing. If you are hearing some sort of like, you know, like booms here and there or like clacks like that one, I don't know if you can hear it, but it's my cat. She's extremely hyper at this very moment in time. I'm recording this video at 11:57 in midnight and I'm not sleepy yet. So I'm just like, okay, let's record a video. Anyway, so the very first tip that I have for you people who are real estate agents, property managers, real estate owners, or whoever you are who are planning to sell a real estate listing, number one, take videos of your listing, okay? So when I'm looking for a condominium unit, I usually go to lamoody.ph, I think, and then trovit.ph, .property, and then property24, and we also have RentPad, and then what else do we have? There's so many websites in the Philippines that are allowing people to see these specific listings, and I have successfully found a lot of listings there, contacted with a couple of real estate agents here and there. But the one thing that I'm incredibly, you know, like I wish we have this, is a video walkthrough of the listing. If you're going to look at real estate properties or real estate listings in the US, not only do they have videos of the listing, but they also have a virtual walkthrough of that specific listing. And that what makes it sell is because even before the person arrives to the listing or to the unit or to the place to view the unit himself or herself, he already has an idea on what it looks like. Because if you're going to just rely on photos, it's actually a little bit difficult to try to stitch it together and understand what the space really looks like. So what am I talking about? There are photos that are just the living room, then just photos of the kitchen, photo of the master bedroom, photo of the second bedroom. And that's okay, that's fine. You can see the listing very well, or you can see what it looks like very well, but it's very hard to stitch it together. Is the living room beside the master's bedroom? Is the master's bedroom beside a toilet? How big is that toilet? What kind of stuff? Like, there's so many lapses in terms of really stitching those images together in your head to form a house or to form that very listing. So it's a little bit hard. And with video walkthroughs, it's easier for the person to just watch the video and be like, oh, okay, so in this area, there's a living room when you go in, and then a few meters is the master's bedroom, and then a little bit far to the left, you can see the kitchen, you know, that kind of stuff. There is already a walkthrough even before the tenant, or the prospect rather, looks at that very unit. And that poses the question, what is the tenant or what is the prospect going to do if we send a video and they come to see the unit in person, or the listing in person? Well, if the person already saw the video, the reason why that person would want to see the listing himself or herself is to simply justify the distance or the space between each part of the unit or the house or the listing, right? So it's really just up to them. Okay, so it's really actually a huge place. This is it. It fits like 3-5 people, because sometimes in a video you can't even see that, or you wouldn't be able to decipher that one. So at least in a video, they'd be able to stitch the image together to form that perfect imagination or visualization of what the listing really looks like in person. And then they arrive to the site, they look at the specific listing, and then they would be able to find out more about the distance, the space, and how it really looks like in person. So the visiting is actually just a cream of the crop. You know, like, you could do that. This is like one of my frustrations as a prospect, is I find it extremely hard to stitch one image to another to actually form the look of the listing inside my head. It's just completely difficult, especially if the photos are completely scrambled. It's like when you enter the door, there's supposedly a kitchen already, and then the first photo that you see is the master's bedroom. Like, it just doesn't make any sense. Like, I would want to see how it looks like when I enter the door, right? So that's one of the things that I feel would highly improve a real estate listing, just by creating videos of the walkthroughs. And how would you be able to create videos of the walkthroughs? One tip, you can use a selfie stick. Selfie stick is not as stable as gimbal systems or stabilizers, but they're way better than your shaky hand, especially if you have a phone that does not have an image stabilization. So phones that doesn't have image stabilization, Oppo, some of Vivo's phones, I'm not saying that all Oppo devices does not have image stabilization, but usually if you're going to create a video with those phones in mind, they're usually extremely shaky, right? So you can avoid that by simply using selfie stick, which is what, 100 pesos, 200 pesos to buy a selfie stick. If you have more budget, then you can start using cell phone stabilizers. There's a lot of them in Lazada and Shopee. And then if you want to level up even further, there's this thing that we call cranes. So there are Zhiyun cranes, I think it's called. They have for phones. They have ones that are also for DSLR. There are also ones that are from DJI, which is one of the top places that you can buy a stabilizer from, or even a mobile stabilizer. And that's just what you need to do. A good phone with, you know, better quality videos, and then a stabilizer, and then you just walk around the listing, try to virtual tour the person who's watching the video. And that would like increase your sales, I would bet, like 2 to 3 times, because some of the photos are actually not taken well. Some of the photos are just very hard to stitch in their heads, right? And so another problem would be like these websites that I mentioned earlier, I'm not sure if they even allow video uploads, okay? So the solution to that is, if a client or if a prospect is extremely interested with that listing, you can send the video walkthrough via Viber, WhatsApp, or Messenger. And then from there, you can start selling it, you know? So whatever the decision of the person is, they can extremely be like, oh, okay, I don't need to visit the room anymore or the unit anymore. Can I just like move in tomorrow? Something like that, right? You wouldn't know. So it not only saves you time, but it also saves your prospects time. They don't need to pay for fuel, gas, or transportation. They don't also need to block time in their calendar just to see the listing, unless they really, 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 really want to. Second point, if you do not have the means to take videos, take better photos, or better yet, hire a photographer to shoot photos of the listing that you have. The reason for this is because I have encountered so many listings wherein they take photos of the utensils, the curtain, the power breaker, the lights, and I'm like, that's not what I'm here for. What I need to see is the photo of the place itself as a whole, right? That leads me to my third point, which is stop selling your prospects to listings they don't like. So multiple times I have talked to real estate agents and property managers wherein because they are desperate to sell a listing, they would sell me a listing that I don't like. And when I'm saying no, I actually don't like this listing, it's not enough for me, they would try to sell me that listing again. And I don't think that it's a bad thing, but at the same time, it's actually not nice, I would say. I don't know, how do I put it? But to me, it's just that I already said no, it would be nice if you can respect my decision and try not to sell me on something that I don't even like. That's a big one for me because I get that people are hustling, and especially in this trying times, unprecedented times of coronavirus, as I'm recording this video, there really are real estate agents that are, you know, they just really want to sell a listing so that they can earn money, and I completely respect that. But I think that as a good property manager, as a good real estate person, you would make your client or your prospect happier if you actually sell them to the listings that they like, you know? Like, you try to find listings that are suited to what they really like. So you can even ask them, like, what listings have you searched in the past that you actually look like? Even if it's not under your name, or even if it's not your listing, just ask, which of these listings do you like, or which of these listings in Dot Property, Lamoody, or RentPad have you eyed on? Can I see it so I can find a listing that is similar to your taste, right? So when a client says, I don't like this listing, and then it gives you kind of like a vague idea of what that prospect really wants in terms of the listing, then you can ask them, can you give me like a list of listings that you looked into this website, and maybe I can find something very similar for you that I have so I can help you out, right? That's more of like a better way to sell than trying to like push this person to taking this specific house or unit or listing that they don't even like. At the end of the day, it's actually their money that they are spending and you have no control over it. And so it would be really great if you could be of great assistance to them by selling them something that is suited to their taste, instead of trying to push them into a listing just because you want to sell a listing. And you will be deemed to have better quality service than other real estate agents or property managers out there if you do exactly just that. Another really good marketing technique that I can share to real estate agents and property managers is, if you want to sell a listing, do not even rely on organic traffic. Like, organic traffic is good because then you can really tell, like, oh, this person is actually extremely interested in this listing because he contacted me through that rental property site or whatever that is called, right? And that's cool, that's fine. But what's even better is if you run ads and you use that video walkthrough that I explained earlier as an ad creative, and you just put a couple of hundred pesos to fuel ads and you have that ads running, okay? So that one is a really good advice, because then you can just target people who are very much interested in rental properties and stuff for rent, and then they'll be able to see that ad in their newsfeed, and then voila, you would have a lot of inquiries just by, you know, putting in a couple of hundred pesos in your local area, right? If it's a local area ad, then it's a little bit cheaper than a national area ad, right? So if it's just in your local area, then the better, it's a little bit cheaper, just put in a couple of probably like 500 pesos or 1,000 pesos a week for that very ad. Whatever walkthrough video you created for that very listing, put that in Facebook ads, run ads on it, you got a lot of inquiries, right? So there's that for real estate agents and property managers. One that I also would like to tackle on is the people who actually own the place. Okay, you just have a property and you want to sell that property, whatever that may be, whether land or whatnot, or specifically in terms of houses and residential units, I would highly suggest that number one, do not cheapen yourself in terms of furniture. I have seen this multiple times over and over and over again. These places with a lot of space, like really wide, large spaces, and then they would just like buy a folding bed or a folding sofa bed to accommodate the person who would want to rent the unit or the space or the listing. So if you're going to cheapen your furnitures, no one would actually want to stay in there because you are going to sell the person through the image of the home that they want to live in. If you're just going to buy, okay, I'm going to buy this cheap ass chair because it looks fine and you can sit on it and that's about it. It's within my budget, so on and so forth. You have this kind of like reasons why you want to, you know, just purchase this cheap chair so that you can put it in your listing. And then what happens is if your real estate agent or your property manager or yourself is going to take a photo of your listing, it's not that appealing because you tried buying all these cheap furnitures, it doesn't even look good, right? So do not try to buy cheap furnitures, but instead, if you can find a good deal of furnitures that are modern, you can go look into Pinterest in terms of ideas as to how would a living room should look like or how should a master's bedroom look like. If you're going to just try to spend the time to look into Pinterest in terms of that, and then you try buying these furnitures that would look well on photos, then that would extremely be awesome and it's easier to sell. Haven't you noticed that when you go to Airbnb.com and you try to find, you know, places to stay for the night and whatnot, you can literally see all these Airbnb places. They really took a lot of time, effort, energy, and money into buying furnitures that are extremely high quality because in Airbnb, it's all about the hominess, right? And they're trying to sell the place daily. And so, you know, they have to make sure that their photos, the photos of their listing, would stand out better in the crowd, right? That's one thing that you could do is just, you know, buy better furnitures. And that would pose the question, yeah, but I actually don't have the budget for that and I'm just trying to like make ends meet. I would highly say that everything that you put into a business will always have an investment, will always have capital. So if you're already complaining that I don't have money to buy high quality furnitures, you already lost. So don't complain that you don't have prospects or clients inquiring for your place because people would want to stay in a home where they feel secured, they feel like it's a home and it's comfy, it's comfortable, it's secured and whatnot. And it's the experience through photos and videos that you are trying to sell the properties to. So that's what you can do is even before they go to the site, you're already providing them this home luxury experience through photos and videos. And one way of making good photos and videos is through buying really good furniture. But for real estate agents there that are saying, yeah, Demi, like we don't really have control over this, you know, like the owner is really not okay with spending more than this amount of money for furnitures, I kid you not. It would be nice if you even pick the listings that you want to sell. So if the owner does not even make a lot of money or the owner does not make a lot of capital for the listing to be sold, don't even work with them. That's what I'm saying, right? Because it's like a domino effect. If the owner is not going to invest a lot of money on the furniture to make good photos and videos, and then it's going to be passed on to you as a property manager or the real estate manager, then real estate agent rather, you'll have a hard time selling that thing, right? So, you know, as a real estate agent, you can definitely choose the listings that you're going to take care of and spend your time marketing for, right? So don't even waste your time marketing for something that is not going to sell, and you know very well that it's not going to sell, okay? And there you have it. Second one, owners, prioritize internet connection. I know this is another limiting belief. It's like, oh, I don't really have a tenant for the next 6 months and I'm going to be paying for an internet connection that I'm not even using. I came across this wonderful woman from one of the real estate properties or real estate listings that I initially wanted to get because she has an extremely fast internet connection. Like she got like 100 Mbps and she hasn't been living there, but she's continuing to pay for it because she highly believes that, you know, having these smart TVs and all and Alexa on her home and whatnot, it needs to have an internet connection. And she really like invested awesome furniture, facilities, amenities and whatnot in her listing so that it will become even homier, right? And she's not living there. Like she literally has a different place, you know, she's literally living in a different house. And that's what I like about owners, is that you're prioritizing internet connection because, hi, Philippines is actually one of the internet capital of the Philippines, or social media capital of the Philippines. And so it only makes sense that each of the listings that we have, or each of the houses that we are looking to for people to rent for, they have internet connection, okay? And so you don't need to hassle the tenant for, oh yeah, you just have your own internet installed, and then when you leave, you can also have it pulled out and then transfer it to a different place. It has happened all the time. This is like a big problem for me because I work from home and, you know, I love internet connections. I love social media. My work is here. So apparently I do need an internet connection. And so to some people, they don't see that kind of need because, you know, I'm not staying in that very unit. I'm just having it rented. It's no point for me to have an internet connection installed, but I dare you not. If your place has a really decent internet connection, they're more likely to stay there because everyone's just in internet nowadays. You know what I mean? And the ones that we have in our phone, people will be saying like, yeah, it's okay. People have internet connections in their phone. Yeah, but it's limited. You can't even go live. You can't even do like messenger call. You can't even FaceTime someone. You can't even call someone through, you know, like through messenger and whatnot. There are so many things that are limited when it comes to mobile data. So it would still be really nice if you have an internet connection there. So to the people who are saying, yeah, I don't have a tenant for the next 6 months or 2 years from now, it's okay if you keep on paying for that internet connection because it will all be shouldered by the next tenant that is going to rent the place. What am I referring to? It only means that internet connection that you're paying for monthly, even if you're not making any sale, it's going to pay for itself, okay? Consider it part of your out-of-the-pocket expenses or whatever that may be, but it's still extremely worth it to have it there, okay? So I mean, you know, it's just me. If you're not going to follow that advice, it's also up to you. But in all properties, not all, but a lot of the properties in the US, if they're going to have it rented, they always have an internet connection. Also, another point to consider is that if you have an internet connection in the listing that you have, it's more likely to sell than the ones that do not have internet connections, right? You've seen that multiple times in Airbnbs and whatnot, right? Okay, last one for property owners. One thing that I really, really like in terms of renting, or in terms of, yeah, renting places, one place after the other, is that there are really tenants that, not tenants, but there are property owners that really take care of their tenants. And I remember very well when I started hitting 100K a month, I rented this condo unit. And it was an extremely small studio space, but the owner was like awesome. She would put, every single month, she would try to give us like goodies, right? So when we arrived at the place, there were goodies there, like water, Pepsi, Coke, and it was all for free. And it was cool, it was awesome, you know, like just so you would arrive. Airbnbs, if you have an Airbnb listing, exactly do this. Like do some complimentary freebies that you can put so that when your tenant would arrive, it's like a nice surprise, you know? Like there's a complimentary water and then dried mangoes and then Pepsi and Coke and whatever that is. And so it would make them feel that they're actually welcome, you know? It would make them feel that they're home, right? And even for listings that are long-term, you can also do that. When your tenant arrives, you can have like, you know, water, right? Because usually when the person moves in, that person doesn't even know where to get water. And so it's only right to put like at least a gallon of water there for initial take-ins, right? So yeah, there you have it. The more freebies you're going to give for your tenant, the more they would give you a higher review, which is awesome because they feel like they are being taken care of. A lot of the times when you are selling a listing, like what I said earlier, you are not actually selling a place. You are selling an experience, okay? And when you are trying to sell an experience, it's much, much better if you double your effort on it, because the better experience that person is going to have, the more likely are they going to give you a good review, the more likely are they going to love you. And when you are having this service type business, the more they love you, the more would they recommend you to other people. And I was even very, very motivated to help this one property owner. Like she was an owner and she has like a right-hand person that does the, you know, does this stuff for us or like tells us what to do and whatnot. And both of them, like the property manager or her right-hand person and the owner, they're both extremely awesome people. And I was extremely motivated to help them market the place when we left. But, you know, I was also struggling at that time, so I didn't really help them, but it's kind of like utang na loob, basically. Just because I felt very homey and I felt very comfortable, safe, and being taken care of in that very place. I think we rented that place for a year, I think? We rented that place for a year and I was like, it was home. And I would always remember that it's home. So until the day I die, I would definitely think about that place and be like, yeah, that was an awesome place. That's when everything's changed for me. And I would remember that owner and I would remember that property manager that we had because they were just extremely awesome. Alrighty, so there you have it, guys. I hope that this has been a great help for you. I'm sorry if it's a little bit longer than expected, but I hope that you got a lot of bits and pieces that you can use so that you can market your listings. And if you are in another niche, say for example, you're not a real estate agent and you're watching this video and you want to also have a very specific advice on how you can market your niche, comment in the comment section, tell me what your niche is, and I might be able to create a video for you. And if you're new here, welcome, welcome. My name is Demi Bernice. I produce one video per week. And if you'd like to know more about digital marketing and marketing yourself and creating digital products and anything that can help you create your ultimate freedom through using internet connection and digital marketing, just make sure to like this video and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!